Government of Guyana is working to help stimulate local small businesses, farmers, and the economy through several initiatives, including small business grants and training. Over 500 persons have already applied to benefit from relief grants set apart by the Ministry of Business through the Small Business Bureau. Speaking during an interview with InfoHub, Minister of Business Hemraj Rajkumar explained that a new agency has been set up to organize assistance for small businesses and farmers. The Coordinating Agency for Small Enterprises, CASE, was set up under the leadership of President David Granger and is aimed at supporting farmers and small business owners and employees.
CASE, as we would normally, we refer to it, it comprised of agency from the Ministry of Business and the Ministry of Agriculture, and part of its responsibility is to develop measures that would alleviate poverty, create employment, stimulate domestic production and consumption of locally produced goods.
Chief Executive Officer of the Small Business Bureau, Dr. Lowell Porter, said that while all businesses are encouraged to apply for the relief, priority will be given to certain categories of businesses.
We're looking for those who are in the food business, agro-processors, value-added. But the bottom line is you come to us and we will start talking.
The Government of Guyana is encouraging citizens to buy more locally produced products in order to support small businesses and to stimulate Guyana's economy.
We recognize that our small businesses, our farmers, their main activity is farming and producing agro-processing and producing manufacturing things in our country. So if we can stimulate the activity, produce more locally, we encourage our citizens to buy more local things. Then therefore you will indirectly support our local industry.
The Council of Ministers has approved the use of local products procured from small businesses, farmers, and agro-processors for use by the Civil Defense Commission during its hamper distribution exercises. Leticia Isaacs for InfoHub.